Good afternoon. I am Deepak Phatak, principal investigator of the T10KT and some other national mission projects. On behalf of the outreach program, I welcome all the remote centers, the students and teachers who have assembled there for this very special event. Ordinarily, as some of you would know, we use this outreach primarily to train teachers and also provide some kind of workshops and courses on specific topics. Today, however, we have come here to listen to some of my colleagues describing the postgraduate programs, in particular the PhD program and the research opportunities, and more specifically on the very exciting activities that are being carried out by Sitara. I'm very happy to welcome on stage here Professor Narayan Rangraj, our Dean Academic Programs. Welcome, please. I will request Professor Narayan Rangraj later to give a brief introduction to the general programs and research at IIT Bombay. And subsequently, the speakers will be the two heads of Sitara. Well, Sitara actually has only one head, but there has been a recent change of head. So let me first welcome the current head, Professor Rangan Banerjee. Welcome, Rangan. Professor Rangan Banerjee actually has been instrumental in many activities here. He was our Dean R&D earlier. He also headed, and in fact spearheaded, our activities on the energy front by establishing a department. And last but not the least, let me welcome Professor Milind Soni. Milind Soni is currently head of Sitara. Sorry, he was the till last week, he was the head of Sitara. He also happens to be my esteemed colleague, Professor, Department of Computer Science. And due to his penchant for making a difference to the society at large, particularly in the rural areas, he spent 3 years instructing Sitara, actually engaging academics in specific design, specially designed programs. So I'm glad to have this Trimurti of IIT Bombay today to speak to you. We will, as usual, I suppose, after the presentations by my colleagues and by some of the students, we'll have some interactive session where people would be welcome to ask questions. As the remote center coordinators would know, the physical interaction might be limited. So those of you who have questions while you are listening to them, they're most welcome to send the questions through chat and email. Our staff will consolidate those questions, and maybe some of my colleagues will answer them at the end. Without further ado, I would request Professor Narayan Rangraj to start the session formally by introducing the research activities and the postgraduate programs at IIT, and this would be followed by the talk by Professor Milind Soni, by some students, and maybe I'll request Professor Rangan Banerjee to coordinate the question answer session at the end. Thank you so much. Unfortunately, I have to go out for a board meeting. That's why I'm dressed so funnily here. So I'm afraid I will not be here. But as you know, we record all the proceedings, and I'll certainly watch the interaction and the talks later. Thank you so much. Welcome once again.
Yeah. Good afternoon, everybody. I am Narayan Rangaraj. I have also recently taken over as Dean Academic Programs at IIT Bombay. So I would like to tell you a little bit about the postgraduate programs at IIT Bombay. So the first thing to say is that the institute has a large number of postgraduate students and postgraduate programs. In fact, I think right now there are more postgraduate students at IIT Bombay than undergraduate students. So we are definitely moving to a research focused institute apart from you know, teaching programs. So the programs where students in particular play a very active role in the research agenda of the institute, that time has come. It is now firmly on that road. So in particular, the research programs and activities at Sitara you know, provide a very exciting and sort of innovative way of doing research as far as our institute is concerned, and they have done many new things, and there's much to look forward to in this area. In particular, research activities oriented towards fieldwork, solutions, technologies, and schematic views of technological deployment, which are actually carried through to a certain level of completion with society and its constituents in mind, rather than only, you know, hypothetical recipients of these solutions. So anyway, I would like to say that the main right now the main academic programs structured activities are M.Tech and PhD programs for Sitara students. M.Tech is a 2-year fixed duration program with about half its component as directed coursework, and about half, actually a little more than half, the duration in a series of project activities which lead to a M.Tech dissertation. So that is one of the bridges between guided research and completely independent research work done by students. So the PhD program, like in many universities all over the world, is largely based on a dissertation written by the student, based on independent work carried out by the doctoral student, and there is a fair amount of independent work expected to be done by the student. So it is an open-ended program, which is a bit scary for many students who are doing this for the first time, because it is not a fixed duration do as you are told program, but it is something where a student learns to become an independent researcher. But it provides a lot of exciting opportunities to make some contributions on one's own. So the PhD program at Sitara, also the rest of the institute, is a growing one with increasing opportunities and you know, exciting possibilities. The faculty base is growing, and the type of agencies and organizations associated with Sitara and the institute is increasing, and we see you know, a lot of good possibilities from the M.Tech and PhD programs. So in summary, actually for both M.Tech and PhD, there are a number of avenues for entering the program through. So M.Tech is after an engineering degree, a normal engineering degree in the Indian setup. But for those who want a scholarship through the teaching assistantship scheme of the government, they have to come through the GATE exam and qualify through that and then apply. Others can also apply through a number of other channels, through projects, through sponsored modes, through self-financing, through there are avenues for college teachers and others. For PhD, the entry is through a number of different streams also. One can apply for a PhD immediately, I mean with a bachelor's degree also, but with some amount of work experience, or else after doing an M.Tech or an MSc degree. So there are actually a number of different admission options and entry options to the program. So the program website as well as the institute website will give all these details, and you know, we will try to be responsive regarding queries and clarifications you may want. There are also a number of other programs in the institute, both in traditional departments and a number of interdisciplinary areas and programs. Sitara is one of the most exciting ones, which has taken off in the last few years, and we really look forward to the outcomes from these research programs in Sitara. So I think we have a faculty base of more than 550 in IIT Bombay, and I think a large number of faculty are directly or indirectly involved in Sitara and a number of other interdisciplinary programs in the institute. So in terms of subject area and area of work, there is a lot of flexibility and versatility which is possible. So people with all department backgrounds and interests are encouraged to look through our programs and apply, and you know, we look forward to interacting with as many people as possible through this outreach activity and any other way which you would like. Okay, there would be questions, there would be faculty from Sitara and students from Sitara who are waiting to interact, or I can also answer questions later on by email or whatever means.
So
So thanks everybody.
Okay, welcome back. So you must have seen an earlier video by me, which is on Sitara website. So I'm Milind Soni. I'm from Sitara. I teach at Sitara. And welcome, good afternoon, and welcome you all for a small introduction to Sitara, its programs, what sort of projects it does, and what can you do after this. So welcome first of all to the big development agenda of India. And so we have offered for you two postgraduate programs, the master's and the PhD program. So by the way, if you have any questions, you should definitely send me an email or raise your hand in the software. So first of all, let me start with Sitara. It started in 1985. It was a platform for faculty members and students of the institute to come together and try and solve development related problems. So after 20 years of experience on solving problems and doing studies, we started the MTech and PhD program in 2007. And it was, the basic objective was to create the development professionals and actually training engineers to participate directly in the development agenda. So as opposed to having companies as potential employers, we wanted our engineers to be placed directly in society and work with them. So obviously these needs interdisciplinary skills, and it needs a skill set or a sectoral knowledge which is really encompassing many aspects of society and engineering. So our basic research is in technology and in policy, and our alumni work in many think tanks, consultancies, research institutions, NGOs, CSRs, and so on. So by the way, all pictures in this, most of our 99% of the pictures in this presentation are by students and faculty members of Sitara. So basic philosophy is to actually address the needs of the bottom 80%. Now that's a large sector of India, and its needs are, of course, water, energy, agriculture, livelihoods, and so on. And so we want our graduate students or our graduates to actually understand development situations, analyze them, and from the grassroots to the policy, and give out solutions. So they will work on national, state, and local situations, and help the development process. So so the other third key philosophy of Sitara is to work with the directly work with stakeholders. So they may be gram panchayats, they may be towns, villages, bachat ghats, or who have you. And the research should be as close to implementation as possible. So we try and see, bring your engineering skills right down to the grassroots level and try and create change. So our courses really try and develop this sectoral understanding as well as policy understanding of development situations. So I will briefly go on the so by the way, most of my faculty members are here, and so are some students, so I hope that we get some time to talk with them, right? So our faculty are in various areas, right, from chemical engineering, IT, CS, mechanical, and environmental sciences, and so on, right? And we also have excellent adjunct faculty members from the consultancy field and also from other institutions like TISS. So the coursework is essentially in four main areas. So the first of all is the perspective courses, where we teach you to understand development, its key processes and attributes, governance, the role of policy in governance, and also social science research methods. Then the next thing is sector courses, where we talk about water, energy, and agriculture, and environment, and also some amount of rural planning, electrification, and so on. So these are the courses which are related to the scientific knowledge or the scientific basis of development. Finally, we have project management, statistics, and system dynamics. These are skills which will help you to work in the development sector. And the key or the most important is a 10-week structured or 9-week structured rural homestay, which is compulsory for all students. So this, right, so here is a complete list of courses. It is also there on our webpage, so you can see that. So the summer field stay, or the 9-week or 10-week summer field stay, is the key or the most attractive part of our program. It begins in May and ends in July. So you see the heat of the heat of the summer months, then the drinking water problems and the water situation, and then the first rains and the first sowing, the beginning of the agriculture season. So it's a very exciting time for students, and they really come back, you know, having understood the key issues of development. So, the 10-week rule stay, I mean, there are lots of reports on our web pages, please do see them. So, there are of course many other exciting opportunities. Every course has a field trip, so you will see it in your 2 years, you would have seen about 20-30 towns and villages, you know, many small plants, you know, small plants and industries, factories and so on. So, many pictures and reports are there on, or many videos are there on the web page, please do see that. Besides that, IIT offers many interesting outlets for students, so TechFest is of course there, and of course there is an active technology and development student body, so which also holds programs. So, facilities at Sitara, of course we have a mechanical workshop, we are an interdisciplinary center, so we use, we try and use our own facilities, and if not, we you know, look at facilities from outside the center. So, we have a food lab and a mechanical engineering workshop besides of course the computer lab. And in IIT Bombay, I think there are many facilities which are open to all. So, just two I am mentioning, the electronics lab, which is a PCB design lab, and of course the GIS lab. So, here are some other programs in the institute which work with Sitara. So, RUTAG is the Rural Technology Action Group started by Government of India. It's an outreach program to help NGOs in their technical objectives. Then Tata Center is an upcoming center which will work with, which will work on frugal engineering and developing solutions at the bottom of the pyramid. Then there's an ongoing project with the National Center for Photovoltaic Research, which is on, you know, which is trying to outreach, you know, basically solar lamps for studying for, you know, for household use, and that is a part of the NCPRE, National Center for Photovoltaic Research. So, besides that, we have a lot of MOUs with towns and districts, for example, Parbhani town, which is a district town, then Shahpur, Shahpur Panchayat Samitis, district administration, collectors and so on, and many collaborations with other colleges as well, for Karzat and Islampur in Sangli are two examples. We are also partnering with some, you know, foreign universities, I think with Berkeley we have a close interaction. Then other thing is that we interact with the small and medium enterprise sectors, so jaggery, poultry, you know, chakkis and so on. So, we understand what their problems are, how to design solutions at that, at the SME level, and then we also work with government programs like KVIC, Government of Maharashtra, Government of India and so on. So, as just to indicate that there is a big wide canvas where students get to see live development problems and actually try and influence the conduct of development. So, besides that, there are also entrepreneurial avenues. So, TDSC is a program which is closely, it's a sort of a consultancy cell which is closely aligned with Sitara. Besides that, IIT Bombay has the innovation, innovation and entrepreneurship cell. So, that will, you can also access. So, let me come now to the M.Tech program. Essentially, it has 20 teaching assistantships, 5 fellowships which are by HAL, and then 1 fellowship from NCPRE and 5 fellowships from MORD. So, there are different conditions which are attached to all of these fellowships. So, you should look at the web page for details. So, I will, you know, by the way, so there are, you know, I will not go over this, but let's just look at some sample projects, correct? So, the first project I have here is the development planning of Gram Panchayats. We know that, you know, India has about 8 lakh or 5, you know, between 5 and 8 lakh villages, and each of them need planning for water, sanitation and so on. So, how exactly to go about doing it is one important project. Another project is actually designing rural water supply systems, you know, over, you know, over dozens of villages at a time, you know, so that we can consolidate on good sources of water and try and help the drinking water problem. Then there are of course appropriate technology which is, you know, one can develop solutions at all, you know, all strata. So, for example, on in this here we try and help women carry whatever they have to carry for drinking water. On the right is, you know, chulas and add-ons to chulas which will improve their efficiency. So, on the left here is you know, a new process for herbal oil extraction. So, these are all processes and products for development. Another example is, you know, the analysis or the design of a smart grid, you know, how to have a wide area rural grid, how to understand its performance, what sort of quality issues are there in rural electricity. So, finally, of course, we do a lot of policy and governance, you know, so here are a list of projects which we have done in the policy sector. So, for example, you know, Ganga River Basin project, the policy part was handled by Sitara. Then there was panchayat planning for solar. So this was another initiative by Sitaram. So a lot of these have actually, you know, gone on and have been, you know, passed on to the government agencies. So by the way, finally, let's, you know, there is also the small scale SME, the small and medium scale enterprises. So we work with many, as I said, chakkis, poultries, and so on, and just try and improve their technology. As we know that 80% of India's manufacturing is actually coming from the informal sector, and informal sector offers a lot of avenues for innovation. So here are is my final slide. So admissions, you know, the dates are, you know, issue application forms has already begun, right? The last date for receipt is 16th. So please, and most of it is online. So please visit the web page for more details. And for the PhD program, I think the last date is in a couple of days, right? April 4th. So that's just tomorrow or day after tomorrow. And all admissions is through a written test, and there'll be an interview process. There's a reading list. Please visit the web page and, you know, and get back to us. So visit the web page. Here is the web link. And if you have any questions, call the office, call us, or write to us. So that's it. Thank you. So by the way, we have here a lot of students and a lot of faculty members. So if you have any questions, we will be very happy to answer those.
Hello, good afternoon all. We are here to represent students community of Sitara MTech. I am Indrani. I have done my Bachelor's of Engineering in Information Technology from Mumbai University.
And I'm Sandhya. I've done my Bachelor's in Chemical Engineering from Anna University, Chennai.
Yes, we do have students from various backgrounds like chemical, IT, electronics, electrical, computer science, biotechnology, dairy technology, to you name it, we have students from all the disciplines of engineering in Sitara. So it's a unity in diversity kind of department we have.
And not only engineering, we also have students from architecture and planning and from masters of science. And we would like to give you a brief idea about the courses, as Sony sir already discussed. In the first semester, we have courses in various domains of research that are happening in Sitara, like we have ecology and environment, watershed management, development theory and planning, appropriate technology, and soil, land use, GIS, and agriculture. So in these courses, we not only study the technical aspects of the course, but also the socio-economic aspects and the policy perspective of the course. So in on the whole, we get to learn about the complexities of the development sector in the country.
So by the time we come in second semester, the perspective which we have already built upon in first semester, we work more on that with subjects like social science research methodologies, where we learn to analyze socio-economic and political conditions in rural village with participation of our stakeholders, which are mainly villagers and various institutions like Gram Panchayat and Panchayat Samiti, Jilla Parishad offices, etc. So apart from that, we also get a chance to implement what we have learned in classroom in actual field. We can undertake a semester-long mini project. We call it development protocol, where we actually implement whatever we have learned in our classroom. So we have those projects in various sectors, like drinking water security, municipal solid waste management, energy sector, rural electrification, and many other areas, and our professors are there to guide us through the project. So we get to work actually in the field along with the stakeholder and get a chance to interact with them and implement and get to get actual practical work experience. Currently, I'm working in drinking water security, and we are analyzing a drinking water scheme, drinking water pipe water supply scheme in Shahapur block in Maharashtra. And I'm really proud to tell that Sitara is a technical service provider for Shahapur block, some of the water supply schemes in Shahapur block. So we are actually getting a practical knowledge and hands-on skills where we can groom ourselves for development work.
And now, as she said, in the development protocol, my colleague and I, we are working on municipal solid waste management in the Shahapur block of Maharashtra. So we are currently studying the waste generation patterns and the current waste disposal practices in Shahpur, and we propose to suggest an alternate waste, a municipal solid waste management practice for to the Gram Panchayat of Shahpur, so which is financially feasible and environmentally sustainable. And in this we are interacting with many government authorities, and also we do a lot of field work, and in all the courses that we study through our semesters, we have field visits for each and every course, which helps us to gain a practical knowledge of what we study in each course. So this was a brief introduction about the coursework, and now a few of other students would like to share their experiences and their various projects in Sitara.
Hi, my name is Abhiram. I have a BSc in Botany, and then I did an MSc in Geoinformatics. After that, I worked as a mapper for a few years in a development planning institute, and while we were making development plans for about 15 districts in India for the 13th plan period, we did that by comparing the norms given by the planning commission and then looking at the real life condition in the society. And while looking at those problems and coming up with solutions, we came to know that problems are multidisciplinary in nature, and technology also has some role to play in it, and that's how I got attracted to Sitara. As the professors and my student colleagues have just now said, we get a lot of diversity in project work. So I would like to tell you about the projects that I have done. The first project I worked on was on alternate building materials. There I looked at many of the industrial wastes and also construction waste and how it can be used as an alternate building material. The next work was to come up with a protocol for air and fuel mixtures in a biomass burning power plant in Maharashtra. Then I worked on looking out for additional generation of additional livelihood opportunities in a village, which was a part of my field work. It was in the northern Karnataka district. And then in the end, I worked on understanding the EIA process for large hydropower dams in India, and I looked at Uttarakhand in particular. And currently I am working on to come up with a protocol for conservation action for the mangroves in Mumbai. So we can see that we get to work on a lot of variety of subjects in here, and after passing out from Sitara, I plan to join the institute back and work as a technology consultant. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I am Siddharth. I have done my BTech engineering in civil engineering, and most of my work during my BTech is concentrated on construction and its management. On some of the field visit I have done in my BTech in rural areas, I got to know that the problem is not only of technical or social or economics, they are of combination of all three, and I have not learned how to deal all these three in a single hand. So before coming to this department, I actually talked to many seniors and also gone through the course that is offered by this department. And the best thing that I look in the course is they are interdisciplinary, and actually I can relate the actual conditions with my knowledge. So the course that I actually wanted to learn is appropriate technology and social science research methodology, in which I actually try to correlate the things with life situations. So I want to just two main things that I also want to talk about is, first, my 10-week field stay. I went to a village in Chhattisgarh of Khukri, village named Khukri in Chhattisgarh state, and the main thing that I look in that village is the natural resources of the village is the main you can say employment opportunities for them, and most of them is actually the most of the income of the villages come from the natural resources. And the second thing is, I am working on my for my M.Tech project on conversion of waste to wealth, and also to generate livelihood for the by using local technology. Thank you.
Hello, I am Nishant. I have done Bachelor's of Planning from National Institute of Technology, Bhopal. Just after completing B Planning, I joined Sitara. And as a planner, I always had an interest in community development and how to make cities more livable, cities, towns, as well as villages more livable for the community. I had many thoughts that we can do this, we can do that for making lives better, but I didn't know that how to implement them on ground. So after coming in Sitara, I learned that how you can work with the community. How can you plan for them with the help of community and then implement the plans with the help of community. So right now, I'm doing MTech project in village development planning. So I have analyzed various village development procedures in India, and then I'm trying to come up with the best village development procedure. Then I have also worked on building a decision making system for the Gram Panchayat so that they can make perspective plans for 15 or 20 years for themselves. So while doing this project, I got a chance to work with the local community. Also got a chance to interact with the decision makers, the policy makers, the CEOs of the Zila Parishad, the district collectors, the secretaries, etc. So they gave me an insight that how you can work on the real life situation, on the real life projects, and what are the difficulties you face while doing a real project. So thank you.
Good afternoon, I'm Karishma Bhuya, and I've done BTech in biotechnology from Chennai. I was inclined towards Sitara due to its interdisciplinary course structure and also the impetus that is given on project-based learning. But my main attraction was the 10 weeks rural stay, wherein we get a chance to live in a village and gain an understanding of various sectors such as agriculture, energy, and water. Apart from that, we also conduct a research on the topic of our choice, which in my case was biogas technology. Now, I would like to give a glimpse to you of my village wherein I had gone. I went to Kattan Bhavi, which is a small village in the Belgaum district of Karnataka. Now, each of the students, either we work with the Gram Panchayat or an NGO. In my case, I worked with a social worker. His name was Shivaji Bhau. He's been working in the area since 1972. He's working in watershed, afforestation, biogas, sanitation, livelihoods, etc. When we are in the village, the first few weeks, we try to understand the village dynamics. The way we do it is through participatory rural appraisal activities, which is taught to us in one of our courses. We do things like we map resource mapping, wherein we map the different resources in the village. We have transect walks, where we understand the topography of the village. And we also conduct focus group discussions. The idea is to work with the villages in understanding their own village. Apart from this, we also conduct surveys, wherein we ask questions regarding the land holdings, the energy usage, water usage, etc. We visit various government institutions, mainly the Gram Panchayat, and understand how various schemes by the government are working in the village itself. Apart from work, we also indulge ourselves in various activities in the village, such as farming, cooking. We also enjoy the various festivals that are celebrated there. This way we understand their culture and build strong relationships with the villagers. I would say that the field visit one of the most fruitful experiences where we get an understanding of the village dynamics and the linkages between various sectors. Currently, I'm working, my MTech project is on biofuel production from lignocellulosic biomass, and I'm placed in an environmental consultancy where I would be extending the knowledge that I've gained from Sitara. Thank you.
We've just had a quick overview of the program at Sitara. We've had some of the perspectives of the current students, and we are hoping that several of you would take on this challenge, because the challenge of looking at technology and what it can do in the rural areas is both a challenge and an opportunity. And we are doing this outreach so that we can reach out to more interested people across the country who are interested in participating in this and wanting to make a career in this field. Because this is a field where there is a significant potential for you to make an impact and to actually deal with the real world. So we'll be happy to answer any questions or comments that you may have. Also, we had our Dean Academic Programs making an overall presentation. So in case you have any questions regarding the overall MTech and PhD programs also, we can try to answer those.
1147.
Yeah, sir, I have a small doubt.
So you have the various departments and various activities where they are going for a field work and they are doing their research. So I have a doubt, how come it is related for the computer science students?
So there are several aspects. For example, right from analyzing a taluka bus depot to simulating various processes, like simulating a water supply system, or the usage of GIS for representing and planning development situations, a lot of it is IT. Optimization is also a very key aspect of development. So I think even for computer science, I am myself a theoretical computer scientist, I think there are plenty of opportunities for CS students as well.
Yeah, sir, actually, sir said thanks for that. Sir, actually, it's like a collection of data and we can implement in real time.
Actually, it's not just that. When we look at, when you look at a real life context, it's about analysis, it's about technology, it's about development of tools, it's about the entire gamut. Whether you look at, in almost every field, you look at technology or applications, whether it is the focus predominantly is on urban areas and urban systems, but there is a neglected segment, which is the rural areas, and there are lots of challenges. So almost every domain, there is an opportunity for technology as well as systems and analysis to make an impact.
Okay, sir, thank you.
Yeah, 1322, Charusat University.
Sir, currently I'm pursuing my master's in computer engineering. I'll go with the PhD in those fields. Sir, what are the opportunities for that? I'm still not getting it properly, sir. Sir, will you please elaborate in detail? What are the job opportunities on this thing?
Job opportunities after PhD is completely dependent on what is the field that you want to work on and what are the kind of things. So in a PhD, predominantly you are going to look at either an academic or a research job. And depending on the kind of work and the kind of domain that you are working on, you would find these opportunities. So similarly in Sitara, if you are looking at whether it is analysis or whether it is GIS or whether it is networks and you're looking at applicability, you would have the same kind of opportunities in application-oriented fields or in the academics. Of course, we are a relatively young center, so we don't have too much of a, we don't have numbers to tell you that we have had so many PhDs and what they are doing, but we have we actually believe that our PhDs would be reasonably well integrated either in the academic or in the research field.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, 1103, MPST, Mishirpur.
Myself, Dr. Manoj Kumar Deshpande from Shirpur, which is off campus of SVKM's NMIMS University, Mumbai. And my school is located totally in tribal area. So today, many final year BTech students as well as MTech students are attending this session. I'm really stunned with the idea that how we can take technology to the rural area. Being an institute in a rural area, I just want to understand how Sitara can collaborate with our off-campus and whether it is possible to collaborate by offering some of the project works and internship for our students, and if you want to take it ahead, so what are different ways we can go ahead and strengthen the further relationship?
So I think we will take this offline, but in a simple sentence I would say that we would be willing and we'll work with you to try and see how we can collaborate. So either we can look at your students doing some joint projects, or we can take this offline, but I think this is an excellent opportunity, and we had actually looked at some ways in which we can engage with engineering colleges across the country to look at technology and development and impacts in the rural areas. So there was, we have been looking at TEQIP and other schemes by which we can formalize this collaboration. But I think we would really like to do this. We would like to also mention that we have, across the institute, we have the technology, the TDSL, which we call, which is basically for undergraduate students to do a course project And this happens in summer and it happens during the semester. And this is one of the ways in which we found, even for students registered for other programs, they have been participating in this. So this could be again another model. So what we could do is we could share whatever we've tried and what has succeeded. And then if you suggest the ways in which you would like us to engage, we can do that. I'd like to request some of our faculty colleagues to maybe add.
Yeah, good afternoon to you. I just want to share an example of a project that we are doing with a local engineering college. You know, there are these two colleges, one is in Varnanagar, Chemical Engineering Department, and another is Sharad Institute of Technology, which is in Itzalkaranji. So, you know, like we are working on jaggery making, and as you know, it is made from sugarcane. And sugarcane is not made in Mumbai, and in about 100 kilometers from here, also no sugarcane is made. And so we had this difficulty of transporting sugarcane from a couple of hundreds of kilometers. So we thought, why not work in the area where sugarcane is grown? And the college teachers as well as the engineering students there were so interested that we have taken our pilot unit, which we developed in a place of Varna Engineering College. And they are both the students, they had come here before the pilot was shifted there, and now they are working on this project. So we can always look for such win-win kind of situations where problem is regional and we have some technical intervention, technological intervention, and we can work together. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hello.
It's 1175 Truba College.
Sahu from Truba Bhopal. I want to ask you one thing. In Sitara, can I join the distance learning or teaching for contribution in Sitara? I am from CS stream.
Actually, so far we have not introduced anything through distance learning. Right now, it is all in the it's all standard classroom MTech and PhDs. We are planning to do continuing education programs, but subsequently that may be an idea. Right now, there is nothing through distance in Sitara.
1300 Kurukshetra University.
This is Manoj. I did MTech after MSc. I have two questions. Could you please tell me the criteria which you follow in the PhD admissions? Like, you shortlist the candidate on the basis of GATE, NET, or it is purely on the entrance basis?
The PhD admission happens on the basis of variety of criteria and under various categories. So you can find all the details related to this on our website. So please refer to our website for more details.
We have essentially, you are supposed to give a statement of purpose, and we also have a written test, and then we have an interview, a round of interviews. In this, one of the important things is for a PhD is, apart from your background, is also your intent and some thought of why you want to do a PhD and what you want to do a PhD on. We have put down, if you see on our website, each of the topics that we are offering this year for the PhD. Those are indicative. We can of course adjust a little bit, but basically you have to give some thought into why you want to do a PhD and what you want to do a PhD on. And that has to have some kind of a match with the PhD interests of our current faculty.
Yes, sir. Sir, actually, I wanted to know, like, is it necessary to qualify the GATE exam to enroll the PhD, or there is no need?
There are, at the institute level, there are some rules that we have to follow. So if you do not have, if you are going to take the teaching assistantship, then you need to have GATE. And if you do not have GATE, and if you are sponsored by some organization and you have 2 years experience and your academic record is good, then that's another category. So there are different categories of things. What I would suggest is, if you have a very specific question, put that question offline by mail, and we will definitely address that.
Sir, I have one more question. Like, is it necessary to have a master's degree in a specific subject to enroll in your institute? Have there any constraint, like you should did a master degree in a specific subject?
If you say your question was in our institute, we have different departments and entities. Each department and entity has different requirements. In the case of which is outlined, so for M.Tech in Sitara, for instance, we have a whole variety of subjects, and it's not we don't restrict it to a specific discipline. But then there will be other departments where it is restricted to a particular discipline. So you will just have to check each entity or department and the requirements of that. So I'm not sure whether you think I've answered your question, but that's the best I can do.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, sir. I am Adesh from Department of Computer Science. So currently our BTEC students are doing some social welfare projects for their final year projects. So can you have a link with the Sitara Center and associate our students with your projects so that they can get some more exposure in the social welfare activities?
So I think, you know, I've answered this question for another, for one of the other centers. In general, we do, we will welcome this. Please send us mail with specifics of what you would like, and then we can try and see how we can have the engagement. So we can definitely have your people visit us and participate in some of our existing programs. On other things, depending on what you're trying to do.
Well, yeah, hi. I want to add that, you know, in Maharashtra, for TechWhip College in Maharashtra, we are trying to, you know, start this TDSL series for other colleges as well. So for that, I think what you need to do is, for whatever is development or socially related project work, your Senate has to pass it and give it credits. So once that academic credit requirement of your college is met, then we have a similar course which has academic, you know, academic credit, which has been passed by our Senate. Then we can start looking at your project and our project and see what is in common. And then we can start to develop case studies which will be of mutual help.
So currently we are having an ED cell, Entrepreneurship Development Cell, in our college. And some of these projects are currently being developed in this ED cell. So can our ED cell directly link with your institute? That means on this entrepreneurship development area.
Yes, we do have, you know, we have a sign, and we also have a, another incubation facility. So depending on, you know, if you can outline specifically what you want to get through the linkage, we can try to facilitate that. With your ED cell, what kind of linkage you would like, and so information exchange definitely, and then specifically we can take this offline and look at it. So that this is not necessarily only Sitara, this is probably across all your engineering, isn't it? Entrepreneurship development.
Okay, sir, thanks.
Good afternoon, sir.
1138, go ahead.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
It's Rajalakshmi Engineering College, Tamil Nadu.
I'm doing my master's in, yes sir. Myself, Manohar, doing my master's in computer science engineering. I would like to do PhD. My question is, as a computer science student, how can I contribute to people through Sitara?
So actually, if you, you look at some case studies in the Sitara webpage, you'll see a lot of case studies which do with, for example, just you know, public transport management has a lot of optimization database and lots of problems, then which are really interesting. So I think besides that, you know, if you look at the CSE webpage, you'll see rural networking or getting connectivity. The last mile connectivity has also been a research area in IIT Bombay CSE. So I think, you know, in principle, if you just go out and understand how computers are used, you'll see that there are lots of interesting areas. So I think that I named two: public transport and rural access or communications are two very important areas as a computer scientist where you can work in for development.
Actually, there are several other, you know, even in the computer science department, there are projects which are related to getting information and looking at rural connectivity. So it's not only about Sitara. There are many other projects which are running, education, and so I think there's a whole range of opportunities.
1316 Dronacharya College, Uttar Pradesh.
So my question is, after completion of M.Tech from Sitara, what are the companies and organizations absorbing the candidates, and what are the areas that they are absorbed for?
Currently, many students, almost all of the students in Sitara, the second year students, have been placed. Most of them have been placed in NGOs working at grassroots levels, solving the various problems which we just now discussed. And many of them have also been placed in environmental consultancies who work on environmental issues somehow related to development.
Thank you, sir.
1214 Srinivasa Institute, Karnataka.
First of all, I appreciate Sitara for doing M.Tech or PhD program which can reach the common people. And my question is, in addition to the gate score, whether a special entrance test from your side for a student who can join for M.Tech or PhD? And another question is there is any stipend for a student who joined in Sitara for his M.Tech or PhD program?
Okay, so first thing is thank you for your appreciation of the Sitara programs. We have a test, it's an aptitude test. We also have some reading list on which we ask questions. The M.Tech and PhD scholarships are the same as the M.Tech and PhD scholarships across the institute. So it's M.Tech is about 8,000 rupees per month, and PhD is what now I think it's revised. It's 14, depending on your background, it's like 14,000 rupees per month. So it's the scholarships are at the same level. We do have, this year, we have some enhanced scholarship, which is the HAL fellowships, which are, I think, at about 12,000 rupees per month. Yeah, so essentially, while you do your M.Tech and PhD, your costs are taken care of, at least.
Yes, sir. I'm C.S. Sriramurthy. I have pursued my B.Tech from VNIT and presently working for Coal India Limited. My basic doubt was, this is an interdisciplinary course, well-versed in all disciplines. And my B.Tech was confined to a particular discipline, electrical and electronics. So, is there any basic coursework needed prior to joining for M.Tech or PhD program? Or how can I cope up there, in the sense, when it is covered in all the disciplines?
So, the answer to your question is, in our nature, we have a core where we provide the background that is required. You continue with your basic discipline, and then the additional courses that you need, you can pick up as electives. So the straight answer to it is, you don't need any additional coursework before you join the course.
And one more doubt is that the final thing that matters is the placement. And then placement will be related to our core degree which we have pursued from our B.Tech, or it will be distributed in all the disciplines at the time of placement?
It depends on how you look at your program and what you do. So over a period of time, if you have, you know, if you've been on electrical and then you work on smart grids and you're working on electrical distribution systems, then your placement would be in electrical systems. But if you have worked on electrical and then you've got interested in some other domains, that's fine. So and then you can work in other areas. So we have a mix of all. So it all depends on what you take from it and how you orient the course.
This is from Raju from Electrical Department. I would like to ask one question, sir. So your students are explaining that some of the ongoing projects. So is there any project is going on rural electrification development? If it is going on, give some details about that. Rural electrification development projects.
Hello. Yeah, we have several projects in rural electrification related to the distribution systems, quality of supply, so things like monitoring the quality of supply, putting in instruments and remote logging for energy audits, GIS systems for voltage regulation. There's also things like how our pumping systems affected by under voltage and other issues in rural areas, how are rural markets affected, how do rural markets play with the protection equipment for pump sets. So we have a lot of projects in the electrical area.
We also are, many of our faculty members are part of a national center. We have a national center for photovoltaic research and education, which does both training and research from PV, right from materials to the systems. And in Sitara, for instance, in this current batch, we have one fellowship for the MTech from the NCPRE. So if you're looking at photovoltaics for rural electrification, or you're looking at a PhD in this area, we have two fellowships from NCPRE. So that's another opportunity.
Sir, is there any detail, the project details, ongoing project details on rural electrical development program is available in your website, sir?
I think we do have that, but if you want additional details, please feel free to send a mail and then we will provide that to you offline.
Okay, thank you, sir.
1100, MES Pillai.
Hello, sir.
Mail.
Yeah. Hello, good afternoon, sir. Yes. My question is, what will be the return on degree certificate of the graduate student? Means like if somebody is taking admission in mechanical department, then at the end of the course that will be M.Tech in mechanical or PhD in mechanical engineering. Like what will be return if I complete a degree from Sitara?
M.Tech in technology and development will be written for M.Tech, and for PhD from the institute there is no department written. So you'll just have PhD from IIT Bombay.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
1045, Savita Engineering College, Tamil Nadu.
Sir, my question is in threefold. My first question is, how will you allocate supervisors for this PhD program? In what basis you are allocating supervisors? My second question is, as a computer science graduate, how can I give a solution to our national security? So how can I select problem from national security? The third question is, we are from south. We are often find some problem, water sharing problem in summers. Okay, so is it possible to give solution, technical solution to this kind of problem through technical solutions?
So I'll, you had a threefold question. I'll answer the first part and then pass on the others. The first part is about allocation of PhD supervisors. The allocation will be is done, it's a mixing and matching kind of thing. So we see, we identify what are the interests of the candidate, the students, and the interests of the faculty. And so we try and we will try and do it in a way that no one is unhappy with the match. We do have statements now of existing faculty and their and the PhD topics that have been floated, and based on that we can do that. But in general, we feel that this can be done without, this is not something which will create a problem. Your second question on the national security has several various implications, and one can look at security in different kinds of dimensions. If you look at resource security for regional areas, whether it is energy, water and resources, that also there are, and those are aspects that are being covered by Sitara. The third question about water sharing, I would request either Milind or NC to probably answer that.
Hello. I think it's a very appropriate question for our program, which is actually the technology and development program. The water sharing issue that you told has actually these two aspects. There's a technical aspects of how much water is available, how many cusecs of water is available, which is actually a technical assessment is needed for that. But how do two states share it within a basin has actually more questions than that. You know, it has a kind of, we have to fix the norms or the, you know, which is the kind of policy that we talk about. Then we should have legal ways of actually, you know, implementing these norms. And at the third level, we need institutions which can actually take care of these things, which then comes in the larger policy kind of a domain. To answer your question, you should actually definitely come to Sitara where we deal with both.
Yeah, 1016 KJ Somaya College.
Yes, good afternoon, sir. My question is, what are the LAVI projects available as far as the PhD is concerned? So as explained in the first part, that is a PG program. So I want to know some sort of details about, so that I can think about it and work?
We have actually put these on our website, and I don't know whether we should really go through all of them right now, but you can maybe take a look at the website, and you are also in Mumbai, so you can even come and talk with our faculty. We have made a list of the, I think we have about 15 topics which are put on our website, so you can look at that. You are also free to suggest some topics where you are interested in, and we can see whether faculty would be interested in guiding in those.
1299 Dronacharya College, Haryana.
Good afternoon, sir. Myself, Professor Dr. R.C. Sharma from Dronacharya College of Engineering. I appreciate the initiative of Sitara for the rural development. Now, water is the major problem in the rural area. What happens earlier that there was a policy from the government of India that each small canal, each small tunnel, was blocked by small dams. So the water collected in that dam was not useful. At the same time, the aim was to uplift the water table. That was also not fulfilled. So, is there any project in Sitara to look into the matter so that the rainwater can be collected at a single place in place of small ponds, so that that water can be used, be utilized? So my question is, is there any project in Sitara to look in this matter so that the water problem in rural area can be uplifted?
So we have a colleague in civil engineering, Professor Eldo, who's been extensively working on rainwater harvesting. And we have also several of the Sitara projects which have been looking at the water's solution, both in water problem, both in terms of technology as well as policies. Explicitly looking at rainwater harvesting as a main solution in the rural areas, some case studies are there, so you can look at some of the case studies that are there on our website.
1311 Arunai College, Tamil Nadu.
Hello. Good evening, sir. Can you give me some example for scenarios where technology based on engineering being implemented in rural areas?
So as Professor Soni showed you a few of those examples, you know, instead of the improved cook stove, you had these twisted tape inserts which can look at your normal chula and can improve the combustion characteristics. There are several others which Professor Shah will.
Yeah, let me give you one example where we use simple thermodynamics principle. You know, you might have heard about this Siddhatila process, which is used in extracting herbal oils. So the conventional process, actually one uses open pan, and the temperature at which the oil, the extraction is done is at about 95 to 100 degrees Celsius. And if one uses vacuum, then the same process can be done at much lower temperature, that is 50 to 60 degrees Celsius. And the product quality is also very superior. So based on this laboratory bench scale work, tabletop work, then we sort of, you know, built a scaled up model wherein 50 to 60 liters of oil can be made. And in place of 6 to 7 days of batch time, we have reduced that to only 1 day, 6 hours batch time. So by using a simple principle of vacuum, we have done that, and we have something like 4 to 5 of such units of herbal oil extraction which have been disseminated in different parts of Maharashtra here. One of my colleagues here will give you Okay, so another example is like, you know, the bull's trench is used to make the fire the bricks, and which is again a batch process. And we have this technology which was initially developed in China called vertical shaft brick kiln, VSBK. And this was somehow not popularized, very popular in this part of the country. One of the project deals with building such a pilot kiln on the user side and testing it and performance evaluation for that. So these are some of the examples of live engineering problems, how we have sort of, you know, use them in disseminating the technologies.
1312 DMA College, Tamil Nadu.
Hello sir, good evening. We are from DMA College of Engineering, Civil Engineering Department. We like to know that if our final year civil engineering students are permitting to do the project in this area, that is doing project only for 3 months along with Siddhara or along with the MTech students who they are doing here.
That should be possible. We have an institutional rule of some project. There is some minor fee which is charged in the academic office, and but I think that should be possible. Of course, it all depends on the numbers and our ability to tackle those numbers with the number of faculty that we have. But yes, for a few people, we could probably do that.
Sir, in that case, when we have to contact you, sir?
Well, depending on when you want the project, maybe a few months before that.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Kurukshetra University, Haryana.
Sir, my question is, do you assist in incubating some social entrepreneurship ideas, like if we have some models? So do you assist in incubating those projects?
We have in our, at Sitara, that's not been a focus. In the institute, we have a technology business incubator. But if you are looking at incubation opportunities for social, you'll want to look at that, maybe you should contact Professor Anil Gupta at IIM Ahmedabad with the Honeybee Network and the Srishti Network, and that may enable you better.
1275 BH Gardi, Rajkot.
Yes, sir. I am Mayur. I am actually studying ME CAD CAM in a second sem. Good afternoon, sir. As a being a remote center, what kind of advantage we can get from IIT Bombay for research work? Actually, I am interested to start my research work in corrosion and in its control. Please give a guideline, sir.
Okay, this is probably outside Sitara's scope, but we have. You'll have to contact the material, the Department of Metallurgical Engineering and Material Science, and we have a couple of faculty members who work in corrosion science and engineering. In this, you would have to define what you want from the institute, and if possible, the relevant faculty may be able to. So you may be able to use some of our facilities. Again, something that we can't commit to right now. You have to do this offline.
Sir, which kind of advantage we can get as a remote sensing center from Sitara?
I guess, is it remote sensing or is it remote center?
As a remote center, right now we do not have any of our courses through distance, but we tried this as an outreach method. Having seen the power of this method, it is likely that we will run a few courses through this, so we may do that. So right now there's nothing specific that we as a remote center, but if you have any specific thing that you would like to have from Sitara, please do write to us and we will try to accommodate the request.
Another question.
Yes, please.
Yes, sir. One of my colleagues have completed his bachelor in industrial engineering and master in CAD CAM. Then what is the scope in Sitara?
For
PhD.
Actually, there is scope if you're looking at rural industries and you're looking at any specific thing related to that, and there could be scope even in there could be scope in Sitara for that background, because we do not prescribe specific backgrounds for our students, but we do check whether the person is actually genuinely interested in working on applications for the rural areas.
1047 SDM College, Karnataka.
I'm pursuing M.Tech in CAD Structures, a branch of civil engineering. I have two questions for you. The first one is, what is the fee structure and course duration for PhD program in civil engineering field? And the second one is there any distance education or part-time that I can pursue my PhD through Sitara?
For the first question, I don't often know the fees. They are specified in the academic in our website. You'll have to just check that. For the second question, if you are a sponsored candidate or a college teacher category, once you do your coursework, and then if you then one can actually, and you are working somewhere else, it is possible to do an external PhD at the institute. You can check the exact rules which are there on the website. If you have any doubts, please feel free to send mail and we'll be able to answer those.
Thank you, sir.
1309 Silicon Institute, Orissa.
Good afternoon, sir. I have actually two questions. The first one is I have done my M.Tech in distance mode from Karnataka State University. So first of all, am I eligible for applying for the PhD program? And my second question is, actually I am there in the teaching profession from the last 13 years. And currently I am involved in a transport project for government of Odisha from last 5 years. So there basically what you are doing is the rationalization of the bus routes. Fine. And right now also I have to submit something regarding what enhancement we can do in the rural sector for them. So I will definitely apply for the PhD program if I am eligible. And if still I am not eligible to apply, can I meet you personally to get some detailed idea about what best I can do for the rural transport network?
As far as I understand our rules, you are eligible. Because as long as that is an M.Tech or a master's equivalent program, that should be possible. And then the second thing, of course, we can discuss this offline. Yeah.
1192 MGM College, Nanded.
Sir, my question is, currently I am pursuing my master's degree in electronics and communication engineering. So I would like to know how much research paper we have to publish in international journals so as to apply for your PhD program.
Actually, we don't have any prerequisite of research paper for applying for the PhD program. We do have a test and then we have an interview, but we don't have any prerequisite for research papers.
Thank you, sir. So one more question. As from 1 hour we are listening about what your students have practically implemented some of the projects in rural areas, but what benefits the rural parties or the village level improvement has been, on what basis you have been come across, and what improvement have you seen in the rural areas, sir?
Hello. Yeah, actually we were in Nanded 2 days ago and we had visited Nanded and Parbhani. So, for example, now, you yourself can be involved in the Nanded and Parbhani districts. You know, there are many, for example, Sujal Nirmal Abhiyan schemes in about, six villages or small towns in Parbhani and 7-8 small towns in Nanded. And they need a lot of GIS support, a lot of simulations, and their water supply schemes need better design and better maintenance. So I think just going through your local towns and helping them out with just getting better water supply schemes is a lot of work which you can do yourself in those two districts. We are just back from there. You know, we were there at you know, SGS College on Friday, and on Saturday we were in Parbhani town.
Okay.
Of course, your question was slightly different. Your question was about what differences have we seen. See, the one of the things that we feel that there is now an interest with several of the towns and the rural areas actually giving us letters and MOUs and saying that they would like to have Sitara being involved. So in that sense, we feel that some of our involvement is something which is being appreciated by the rural areas. Over a time period, we don't have a trajectory of a documentation of what has happened over a time period, if that's your question. I think it's a little early for us to say that.
Good evening, sir.
Yes, SSM College, Tamil Nadu.
And is there any internship program provided by you people?
Intensive in what sense?
UG students? Huh? Internship training regarding any project development?
Internship, we don't have a structured internship program, but if some people are interested in some of our areas, we are open to it.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you all, and we hope to see many of you here in the next few months.